Hello, YouTube family. Well, today is December the 10th, and it's 10:27 a.m. And my channel's still here. Well, guess what the very first thing I watched this morning was? Okay, it's a video from YouTube called November 2019 Creator Letter Updates for this year. Now, I didn't realize it, but it's dated November 21st. So it's not real current. So maybe we'll get another one in a few days talking about COPPA, C-O-P-P-A, about the children, you know, and all the stuff we've been worried about and the fines and everything. Well, she didn't mention a thing about it. So I left a comment saying we really need more clarification on this COPPA thing. You know, if we're going to be charged $42,000, oh, you should see the comments. There's $1K under this guy, he wrote, is this a cartoon and bright colors? Dare I say, is this targeted to children? Which it is. It's all cartoons and bright colors. And they had 1K and I thumbed up too. So whatever it is, it's 1,000 plus. And there's funny comments under it. Well, anyway, I hope they take us seriously that we you know, it's absolutely impossible if your way of even doing the gospel is in a cartoonish way, because your way is to draw things out, and maybe you're not Charles Van Gogh or Da Vinci, you know what I'm saying. Most people don't even draw like that anymore. Well, we got a few artists, yeah, like Akion Kramerik, which that's I can't believe Jesus Christ visited her as a very young child. A couple years later, she paints the picture of what he looked like, and it's famous. It's all over. I got it on my wall. The Prince of Peace. And now she's traveling all over the world, checking out all the cultures and painting pictures of them. And that's nice, except that she's accepting their religions. And now she's like a coexist person. And I'm like, I left a comment under one of her videos, and I was like, what are you doing? You get visited by the Lord Jesus Christ himself, and now you're going to follow these false religions and say, oh, it's all coexist. We can all go to heaven. Hey, I want that too. I want that for everybody I know. I would like to see every single person that I know in my whole life and ever have known, have ever had any feelings for, good or bad. I'd like to see them all go to heaven. But if they're not loving the Lord Jesus Christ, and they're not following his commandments, like the word says, obey, if you love me, obey my commandments. That's Jesus talking. He gave us two. We cannot say you have to obey the Ten Commandments if you're not going to follow the rest of them. One of their laws was, if you don't follow the Sabbath to a T, you will be stoned. Moses had to have them stone a man for gathering sticks to make a fire. I mean, come on. Do we really want to follow the Ten Commandments? We can't just follow ten. Because it was said, I don't remember if Jesus said it, it might have been Paul. He said, if you break one commandment, you're guilty of breaking them all. So Jesus died on the cross to pay the price for our sins, and to free the Jews from all those laws. Why should we take them upon ourselves? I ask you. Some people say, well, the Lord told me to keep the Sabbath. But do you realize that Saturday isn't even the Sabbath day? I was listening to a video yesterday. It might have been Steve Fletcher, but I don't think so. Anyway, I was watching several videos. I just wanted encouragement. I wanted to see what people were saying about the rapture. I just, you know, sometimes we just need to be encouraged that, yeah, he's coming. And there's a lot of good days coming up that sound possible. Let's stay ready, okay? But not be crushed to the, you know, point of giving up if we're still here on December 31st, January 1st, January 2nd, and life goes on. We keep watching. We keep waiting. We hang in there. And, wow, not sure how I got off on that. I was just going to share this creator letter. But anyway, they were talking about, what was I talking about? The Enoch calendar and how the Sabbaths are determined. Wish I could remember everything they said. Then I'd have a photographic, or what do you call it when what you hear you remember? That's different than what you read. But anyway, you know what I'm saying. If I could remember everything I heard, that would be wonderful. Somehow the Sabbaths were figured differently for real back when they had to keep the Sabbath. Okay, so why put that burden on yourself? If you feel led to keep the Sabbath, go ahead. But Paul makes it clear, and I did a video on it. Colossians 2. I always thought it was in Romans, but that chapter goes on to talk about who told you don't touch, don't taste, don't do this. Don't let anyone make you feel guilty over like keeping the Sabbath or not keeping the Sabbath, or celebrating a holiday or not celebrating a holiday. Why do you do it? That is the reason. That is the thing. Are you doing it because everybody else is doing it? And are you doing it like everybody else is doing it? Or are you doing it for the Lord? Are you keeping it holy as we should every day? That's what Jesus told me. Just keep it holy as you do every day. Don't drink. Don't get drunk. That's the debauchery he hates. It's the lasciviousness and all the adultery going on, and it does. There was a party going on across the street where they normally have weddings. I don't think it was a wedding. And they were hooping and hollering. I was about to call the police. I said, it's 10 o'clock. Y'all need to shut it down. Well, it wasn't 5 minutes. I'm sure they didn't hear me. I just said it out loud. I was looking out my window, and they were just carrying on. I'm sure they'd been drinking. And I thought, from the lights I saw inside, I said, that's a Christmas party going on. Probably an office party where they can afford to have all the CEOs and executives. You know what I'm saying? Because that place ain't cheap. They probably didn't want to have it at their fine home. Anyway, moving on. The point is, that is what Jesus hates. Carrying on. On a day that we're supposed to be celebrating his coming into the world. And if y'all feel that's wrong, don't celebrate it. Don't let my freedoms interfere with your conscience. That's what Paul was teaching. If I have enough faith to believe it's all right, but you don't, and that is how he put it, you feel guilty about doing it, don't do it. Don't. I just got a very lovely gift from my brother, and it had a Christmas card in it, and it had stockings on it, and he's a Baptist preacher. Well, he was. I'm not sure if the church he has now is Baptist or not, but it had stockings on it, but it had a scripture on it, and I was like, oh, woe is me. The world don't get it. The Santa Claus thing has got to go, okay? And stockings to me says you're waiting on Santa. But then we can't judge everybody, can we? Everybody has to go by their own conscience. If they feel it's okay to send Christmas cards or stockings, okay. I'll get one when I go to the Christmas party. It's just how they, they could put them in little gift bags, but they put our little gifts that they get us in a stocking because the old people get a kick out of it. I mean, come on. They're like 80 and 90 years old. I'm not here because I'm old. I'm saying, all these old people around here, and I'm talking to somebody that's 90, you know. I'm like, oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I don't mean to offend you. It just comes out, you know, I'm not thinking. I'm talking to my neighbor saying about something about all these old people around here. They just don't get it. I tell you what, I have to catch myself and apologize a lot. So, not a lot, but anyway, it's kind of funny. But I'm just happy that my let me double check, make sure it's still up. But I think the main thing we got to all worry about is not to have children in our video, not to make it look like it's for like it could be for children, and it's not, and the content, I don't know. See, I don't know really 100% for sure what's going to get us charged $42,000-some. They need to make that clear. They really, really do. They need to send us all an email or put up a video and make sure we all get notified of the video through our little bell and tell us what exactly will get us charged money, see? Because here is where we are. And I know some people are suggesting GodTube, and that may be good. And some are going to something else, and I got another suggestion yesterday, and that means everybody's going to be going like this, you know, like the Israelites when they were spread out. Or like when God, they were building the Tower of Babel, and they said, God and Jesus said, now they'll be able to reach the heavens or something. Or if they accomplish this, let's see, how does it go? They'll think they'll be able to do anything or something. So he made them all have a different language, and they couldn't understand each other, so they couldn't get the job done. And so they all ended up going their own ways. And that's how we got Spaniards and Irish and Germans and all these other languages. Well, you know, they were scattered and couldn't communicate anymore. And I just would hate to see that happen. I really would. I just would really hate to see this go down before we get out of here. So I'm really praying hard, and I hope y'all will join me. I'm just going to pray right now. Our Heavenly Father, I ask you to please send your warrior angels, and any other angels to send down your net from heaven and grab up the demons that are bringing this about. And put a wall between Satan and and YouTube. If that is possible, put the wall of Holy Spirit fire between them and cover them with your precious blood and make it where they cannot take our channels down. Okay, if they remove one here and one there, a video, you know, Let them do their thing there. As long as we can keep putting up new videos and communicating and commenting, and please, God, I ask you, don't let them take our channels down. Please let us be able to continue to stay in touch. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. And I was working yesterday, I wanted y'all to know, on a new email, because Gmail could go down too. I mean, it could come to that. And it'll either be charter.net or spectrum.com. No, brighthouse.com. It's through the Wi-Fi I bought and my cell phone, which is Spectrum Mobile. I have an email address, jeanniehardesty007@charter.net. And I think I can get email if I go to charter.com. It was a little complicated. I have to work it out, okay? I wanted to get it where when I open up my mail here, where I get Gmail, I can get that mail. But it wasn't so simple, and it was so complicated, and my brain needs instructions like a fifth grader, and that's just the truth of it. Oh, well, I'll keep working on it. And if I have to, I'll get me a new Hushmail account and see if I can add that one. Or anything besides what they're offering. When I click on mail, and I go to mail and add account. Okay, it says I can use iCloud, eExchange, Google, Yahoo, AOL, which we used to have AOL, but it was $25 a month, so I don't know what they're like now. And then it says other mail account. I hit that, tried to enter my thing, and it didn't work. Anyway, I'm working on it, so I'm going to let you go. I'm rambling now. I love you all, and I will talk to you again soon. I guess that's it. Now I'm going to plead the blood of Jesus over this video and the internet connection and my computer and over my content, that the Lord will help remind me to not... I'm clicked off as my videos are not for children. So even though they could watch some of them, I don't specifically make videos for children. And I plead the blood of Jesus over each and every one of you and all of your devices and your internet connections, whatever you've got, so that we can stay connected right here until we leave. And it could be soon. Let's keep looking up, because our redemption draws nigh. Okay, with that, I'll say bye for now. I will talk to you later.